आइटम नौ
वीरेंद्र कश्यप टू कंटिन्यू।
आइटम संख्या नौ श्री वीरेंद्र कश्यप।
बोलिए बोलिए।
थैंक यू सर। सर आई हैव स्टूड अप टू सपोर्ट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन शेड्यूल कास्ट ऑर्डर अमेंडमेंट बिल 2012 व्हिच वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन द लोकसभा ऑन 21 मई 2012 एंड देयर आफ्टर द बिल वाज रेफर्ड टू द स्टैंडिंग कमेटी ऑन सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट ऑन 25 मई 2012 फॉर एग्जामिनेशन। The objective of the bill is to insert certain castes in respect of Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha and Tripura in the Scheduled Caste Order 1950 and to omit entry 3 of the schedule to the Constitution Sikkim Scheduled Caste Order 1978. Today the SCs and STs are grateful to the founding father of the Constitution of India. Especially we are indebted to Dr. B.R. Ambedkar who has put certain constitutional provisions for the upliftment of these communities which used to be regarded as untouchables in our society. The definition of scheduled caste under Article 366 of the Constitution in clauses 24 says scheduled caste means such caste, race, tribes and parts of the groups within which caste, race, tribes as are deemed under Article 341 to be scheduled caste of the purpose of the Constitution. Article 341, which says the scheduled caste, the President may, with respect to any state or union territory, and where it is stated that after Constitution, with the governor thereof, by public notification, specify these caste, races, or tribes or parts or groups within caste, race, tribes which shall be the purpose of the Constitution be deemed to be scheduled caste in relation to the state or union territory as the case may be. Number two, Parliament may by law include or exclude from the list of scheduled caste specified in the notification issued under clause 1 any caste, race, tribe or part or group within any caste, race or tribe, but save as aforesaid in notification issued under the said clause, shall not be varied by any subsequent notification. And under this clause, the said Constitution Scheduled Caste Order Amendment Bill 2012 has been brought here to include certain castes in the list of Scheduled Castes of Kerala. According to the proposed amendments and modifications, Puluwan is to be included along with Paluwan at serial number 46 and inclusion of Thatcher in serial number 61 along with Thandan in the SC list of Kerala state. In Madhya Pradesh, Dahiya is to be included along with Dayat, Dahat at serial number 18 in the constitution. In Odisha, Amata and Amat are to be included as serial number 2 and Bazia at serial number 13, Jagili and Jagil at serial number 41, Buna Pano at serial number 69 in its SC list. There is one more amendment with regard to the change of the heading of part 13 Odisha to part 13 Odisha. In Tripura, Chamar Rohidas Chamar Ravidas is to be included at serial number 4, Dhobi at serial number 7, Jhalo Malo at serial number 12 in the list of SC of the state. In all the above entries, the state government, RGI, National Commission of Scheduled Caste have recommended for the inclusion of these castes in their respective list as being synonym. Now there is another amendment which is regarding the exclusion of the caste from scheduled caste, that is Maji, Nepali, from the list of SCs in the state of Sikkim. In this case, the government of Sikkim has said, as is revealed from the reports of the state government and Sikkim Commission, for backward classes. The Majhis want to come out of social stigma of a scheduled caste. According to them, Majhis are not considered as untouchable among Gorkha, and it hurts their sentiments. And National Commission for Scheduled Caste Commission has concurred with this ruling. Actually, the criteria followed for the consideration of specification of the caste, etc., as a scheduled caste is extreme social, educational, and economic backwardness arising out of traditional practice and untouchability. The Constitution SC Order 1950, as purported in the bill, is supported by views of experts, individuals, organizations, and the institutions in the field of anthropology and ethnography. After promulgation of the Constitution in exercise of power conferred by clause of Article 341 of the Constitution, the President made the following 6 presidential orders between 1950 and 1978 for specifying caste as scheduled caste in relation to various states and union territories. These are the Constitution Scheduled Caste Order 1950, the Constitution Scheduled Caste Union Territory Order 1951, the Constitution Jammu Kashmir Scheduled Caste Order 1956, the Constitution Dadar and Nagar Haveli Scheduled Caste Order 1962, the Constitution Pondicherry Scheduled Caste Order 1964, the Constitution Sikkim Scheduled Caste Order 1978. These orders have been amended from time to time by the various acts of Parliament enacted as per Article 3412 of the Constitution between 1956 and 2007. Presently, 1,208 castes, etc., have been specified as scheduled caste in relation to various states and union territories. It has been noticed that the list of scheduled castes were last revised by the Constitution Scheduled Caste Order Amendment Act 2007. Thereafter, proposals have been received from the state governments of Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Tripura, and Sikkim for certain modification in the list of scheduled caste in these states as stated above. The proposals were processed as per approved modalities. The National Scheduled Caste Commission and Registrar General of India have accordingly conveyed their concurrence to the proposed notifications. To give effect to them, it is proposed to amend the following President's orders: the Constitution Scheduled Caste Order 1950 in respect of Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, and Tripura, and in which 11 castes which are either synonym or the same are to be included in SC list of respective list of the states. Number 2, the Constitution Sikkim Scheduled Caste Order 1978, wherein one caste is to be excluded from the list of SC of that state. Many honorable members of this august house has given many more castes for their inclusion or exclusion from this list. Mr. Nishikant Dubey and yourself, sir, you are sitting on the seat of speaker. Dr. Raghuvansh Prasad Singh has given notices for amendment and inclusion of various castes into SC list. But I also want to mention one such caste, Koli and Kori, which is a synonym, may be included in the list of those states where they are excluded to be Koli and Kori. In Haryana, Chandigarh, Madhya Pradesh, Punjab, Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh, Gujarat, Himachal Pradesh, both Koli and Kori are treated as scheduled caste and are given all facilities of scheduled caste. Similarly, in Maharashtra, Odisha, Uttar Pradesh, and Uttarakhand, Koris are given the benefits of scheduled caste. In Delhi, Kolis are given the benefits of SCs. Here it is to be mentioned that in Delhi, Koris get the SC certificate, and in UP and Uttarakhand, Kolis are not given the facilities due to the reason that these castes, those synonym, do not find place in their respective list of the states. This In Maharashtra also, it has come to the notice that the certificates issued in the name of Kohlis are being cancelled due to this ambiguity. I have continuously, this anomaly should be removed immediately after enlisting these two castes, Kohli and Kori, in Delhi and UP and Uttarakhand, so that the benefits be given to those who are being debarred of such benefits even after long 66 years of free India. I have continuously been pressing the demand of this ambiguity in Kohli and Kori and written letters to the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, Government of India, and also Delhi government, but no results have come up. In this regard, I would like to mention a office note of Chairman SCST Infrastructure Development Committee of Delhi government, which is self-explanatory. I may mention few lines of that note as under. This is in connection with the inclusion of Kohli caste as synonym to Kohli caste in SC list of Delhi. I am to refer to your letter number such and such, dated 6/11/2007, wherein the representation of Delhi Pradesh Kohli Samaj Kalyan Sangh registered was sent to the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, Government of India, Shastri Bhavan, New Delhi. You may perhaps be aware that Kohli and Kohli is used as synonym in almost all the states in India. It is only in Delhi and in this discrepancy has crept in. It is a matter of common knowledge that Kohli and Kohri are synonymous and they belong to the same community and creed. It may also be stated that by using this synonymous name, no additional caste or community is being is added to the list. In fact, they are the same and the one caste. Therefore, these should not be any hesitation in undertaking this change. Similarly, it is to be mentioned here that Barua is the scheduled caste in Rajasthan, whereas in other states it is in OBC. In Uttar Pradesh, Bahilia is in SC list, whereas Aheria is not in SC list, though these two castes are of the same synonym. In this case, the All India Commission of Backward Classes has admitted that Aheria is the sub-caste of Bahilia. In Bihar, Pan Samvasi is synonym to Tanti, Tatma. The people of these castes are demanding that their caste should be excluded from extremely backward classes and included in SC list. I have a representation of Bihar, Pam, Tanti, Samasi, Bunkar Samaj, Uthan Sangh, who has given reasons to their demand, which is to be as under. I am not reading this, but at the same time, I want to refer some observation made by the Standing Committee of Social Justice and Empowerment. This is very important. It says that the committee are constrained to note that as many as 17, 18 and 7 proposals from state governments are for the amendment of FC order for pending with the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, Registrar General of India and National Commission for Commission for Scheduled Caste, Scheduled Tribe, Scheduled Caste respectively. The committee have been informed that there is a specified procedure for deciding claims for inclusion in and exclusion from other modification in the list of Scheduled Caste, requiring consultation with the above mentioned agencies. Since the whole process is long drawn and sometimes it may take many years for state government proposals to reach the bill state, the committee wished to emphasize that a sound system need to be put in place under which each organization, agency involved, that is state government, Registrar General of India, National Commission for Scheduled Caste and Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment are made to follow strict time schedule to process the proposals received so that the benefits may reach the intended purpose in the shortest possible time. The committee hope that the government will take appropriate steps in the right direction. Similarly,
बिहार के कलवार जाति अत्यसवाल जाति को भी शामिल करने के लिए
वो डाल देते लिख के दे दो सर. Even after a long 66 years of independence and 62 years of our constitution, we are not in a position to identify which caste should be SC and which area caste should be included as ST. This is very strange. The government should come forward with a policy so that all such demands are solved once for all. In Himachal Pradesh, there is a growing demand for Hati should be given tribal area status, and other areas have also raised demands to give them tribal status. I have also raised this issue in the House and with the Government of India, as this is the issue of my state and also my Lok Sabha parliamentary constituency. Some questions from the government which the Honorable Minister should reply while summing up the discussion. Whether the amended list would affect the 15% scheduled caste population? Number two, how many such cases were lying pending in the ministry? Number three, why the report of NSC, National Commission for Scheduled Caste, is not discussed in both houses of parliament? Whether it is true that the reservation roster in the services is not implemented in the parliament? Above all, in the last, I want to say few lines about two more demands which is not I'm just coming to end, sir. One thing, the issue was also raised by Mr. Punia today in Zero Hour, that Reservation Act that should be brought in the House and that should be implemented accordingly, because that is pending for the last so many years. If this act is brought and that is passed, this dual caste, dual tribes, they will get maximum benefits. Otherwise, there is a lot of problem for implementing various rules, regulations and acts in this country. Secondly, Indian judiciary system services ki jo hai wo sthapna desh mein ho jaye, taki judiciary mein bhi dual caste logon ko proper representation mil sake. Ye bhi main aaj is house ke samne is bill ke madhyam se, amendment bill ke madhyam se kehna chahta hu. Aapne mujhe samay diya bolne ka, aur sath hi sath jahan
Bihar Uttar Pradesh
madam Rama ji ka bhi hai ek sanshodhan hai ki Delhi Bihar Uttar Pradesh mein बलवार जाति जायसवाल जाति को अति पिछड़ा जाति में रखा जाए, तो वो भी मैं आपको यहाँ पर बता देता हूँ. इन्हीं शब्दों के साथ आपने मुझे बोलने का समय दिया, क्योंकि आज मैं तीसरी बार खड़ा हुआ हूँ और मैं इस बिल को जो है अमेंडमेंट को जो है वो सपोर्ट करता हूँ. इसी के साथ बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.